Now the real question is, can I go over the mountain with the car? Oh, for fuck's sake. The shit won't fucking turn. Why is it doing this? Look at this. Look at this! Fucking garbage. Come on. Fuck's sake. Really? 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 Come on, open the fuck. Oh, for fuck's sake. Where's the car? Nope. We're not doing this. Okay.
I'm not definitely not doing that.
I mean, I would have thought it's an interesting thing. Verifying ID. Clear. And all, but... mean, I expected there to be BTs, obviously, it's a city. But those there are some fucked up ones. What fucks? Can't I go across the mountain? Dude, what the fuck? Obviously, we're not going to do this.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges.
Fuck's sake. So I have to go around, of course. Well, that's just great.
Time now.
200 metal is 200 metal.
Don't forget, Sam. Most facilities have materials you can requisition to fabricate structures and equipment.
Trending more like road building. Oh crap. I did not expect it to go like that, but okay. Should actually be able to build that one too.
No. They are still fucking knocked out. Who the fuck like likes those?
Yeah, I'm still not quite sure about how all of this sharing online works with buildings and stuff.
Okay.
864, so I take 300 from here and I'll take this 63 and I'll take their metal walls. I won't lie, I've rebuilt the shit on the road. Not solely by myself, but still, dude. Again, that's why I don't know how the fuck does this work, the sharing of everything. Well, that one should have 300. Kairan. That's the thing, I already had some roads rebuilt right when I got in here.
Okay.
Hey, Sam. Thanks for coming back. Got something for you. These are your new cufflinks. They still work as a terminal, but I've added a weapon function. I was able to redesign everything from the ground up after the last connection.
And they're weapons too now?
That's right. Cord cutters. I should explain.
Yeah,
the other side via umbilical cords, right? When those cords bring the matter of our world into contact with the antimatter of theirs, boom, void up. But just as Deadman theorized, your blood does have unique properties. It can be used to cut a BT's cord. So I've added that function. Cut the cord of the BT, and it returns to the world of the dead. No BT, no void out. Win-win.
These things can cut them loose.
If you can get close enough without them noticing, yes.
Cord snipping super handcuffs.
Right. Let's try them out.
She already tried them out.
Cut the cord connecting us.
Oh no, she wants me to Oh.
She's sound asleep. Made sure she got plenty of milk.
This is just one fucked up coping with everything.
Set us free. This world was never hers, but all the same, I didn't want her to leave it. Even though she's already lost. Truth is, she's not really my daughter.
She's the daughter of my twin sister. Dum dum dum.
That was all a lie.
No. That part was true. My ovaries can't produce eggs, and Lachna has trouble with her uterus. Long story short, neither of us can have children. I was all right with it. I mean, children, who needs them, I thought. But My sister thought differently. Lachna wanted a child, someone to carry her genes. She fell in love with another member of Bridges, but he died in an accident. She was devastated, of course, as was I. Back then, strong emotions like that, I could feel hers and she could feel mine. When I sensed her desire to join him, to end it, I went to her and said, let's have a baby. We took one of Lachna's eggs and fertilized it with his frozen sperm. And I carried it to term. A healthy baby grew inside me. But then there was the attack. And our bond was severed. I wanted to tell her. But I was bound to the child. I couldn't just abandon her. But I was wrong. Lachna needs to know. You have to break some ties to forge others. Can't be tied to everything. If we're going to reconnect the world, I need to reconnect with my sister first.
Use this click and the void out. Now that would be a good plot twist.
Do it.
What if I don't do it? Okay, whatever. Who was the shadow lady? Drive all the way back there? Will it just skip to there? Oh, shit.
Would you set me up? I haven't been outside in a long time. It's just too much to take in all at once.
Are you sure? Thought you might be claustrophobic after your time in the rubble.
I'll be fine, so long as I can see out of the bag. The warmth of the light, the touch of the wind, the scent of the world. Lucky you. The two of you are still connected. Okay, Sam. Let's go.
a special surprise prepped and everything. But it looks to me like your hands are full.
No biggie. We can always tweak the rules a bit. Do to make it out alive is not get eaten. Sound like fun? Of course it does.
That's so fucking bullshit. I just lost everything.
Thank you.
bullshit! Fucking bullshit!
The hospital I was staying at was crushed by a bridge. Still have nightmares about it. Still hear the crash before it all came tumbling down. I've been scared to death of bridges ever since. And yeah. I know how that must sound considering our employer. I'm scared of the dark too. Sleep anymore. Can't.
Well, then don't sleep in the dark. Sleep in the light. I mean, it's fairly simple. I know it's funny, but
I have to see.
Okay. I mean, I had to try. It would be so fucking funny, like, this is not funny. Fuck's sake. Oh dear God. Let's just hope the car doesn't fucking dismantle itself before I get
there too. Nah. Nah.
you remember your own birth. I remember being inside the womb. I wasn't alone. I could hear my mother's heartbeat. Hers. And Loxa's. We were conjoined twins. One and the same before we were born. Then they tried to separate us. The surgery. Operation was successful. We were still mourned. We knew each other's thoughts without saying a word. My joy was her joy. Your pain was my pain. And no distance was too great for us to overcome. Some might call it a kind of telepathy. Divided in body, joined in spirit. We had a beach just for us. One we shared. Our own private chiral network, you might say. With Cupids, we can build one that will let everyone share what Lachna and I have. I saw it all laid out before me after I signed up with Bridges. A network that could unite everyone, no matter how scattered or different. That would make us whole. It wouldn't be about bringing people into line. It would be about bringing them into the fold, where they would share and share alike. I knew it could change the world. With Amelie's help, we finalized the Cupid design. But after the attack and the birth, everything changed. For the first time in my life, Lachna wasn't there. But I'm not alone anymore. I can feel her again.
All clear. Welcome,
she's close.
Sam Porter Bridges.
Thank you, Sam. I feel whole again. You and me, sis. Sorry, Lachna.
Well, the vehicle survived. Somewhat. She died? Yeah. Yes.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I love you so much. I love you so much.
She did die?
I can hear your voice again.
No.
I shouldn't have kept you in the dark. Tried to save her. I couldn't. You don't have to say it anymore. Lachna, you need to fix his Cupid. I couldn't save our child, but you can save our world. Only you.
Well, she did say that she's connected to this world because of the baby or whatever. Cargo damage, what the hell? Well, all again, I would not say. One is dead, so.
She went through. I had no idea. I thought she'd severed our bond on purpose, that she'd stole our child and ran. I fixed your Cupid like she asked. The limiter should be functioning properly now. There is one thing. Before I sat down to work, I took a long, hard look at the code. I'm pretty sure someone's tweaked it.
Obviously.
My memory's going to pieces.
Someone rewrote your code?
Rewrote might be overstating it. Let's just say it wasn't the latest version I released. And yet, because of it, I was finally reunited with Malingan.
Look at that, it's fucking malignant.
Maybe we found our culprit already. She died beneath the rubble, with our child still inside her. Her ka passed over to the other side, but her ha remained, bound to our dead daughter. She knew all of this, of course. That's why she kept one cuff loose. Didn't want anyone seeing her vitals. Shame she couldn't use her favorite invention. She did all that to keep me and our daughter safe. Sis? I can hear you. We're whole again. We're one. Like before in the womb, remember? Malingan. Hakna.
Malingan.
Thank you.
thanks to you, Edge Knot City is finally within reach. And you, Lachna, your work will help ensure that the Chiron network remains online. Together, we might just make it all the way west. Now then, Sam, there's something else you ought to know. We've been studying the data from when you claim you encountered those soldiers. We had audio, which doesn't paint a complete picture on its own, but the languages, the names, and terms we picked out, the munitions we could identify.
World War II.
Seems to indicate that you were on a battlefield over 100 years ago. World War I, to be precise.
Yeah, I was actually right. I first said World War I.
Maybe you were spirited away to another dimension or something. And given the time discrepancies, maybe you were sent to a beach. Can't say anything for certain. That said, I've never heard of a beach turned into a battlefield. But beaches are shaped by the will of the people who inhabit them. Perhaps Hartman can offer a more rational explanation. Beaches are his specialty. Unfortunately, he's still outside the Chiro network. Anyway, get some rest. No use dwelling on questions we can't answer yet. Your work is greatly...
My poor car. But the shit actually survived, for fuck's sake. Truck repaired, yeah. You cannot teleport from here? Oh!
Lou?
Nee.
Ooh! Looking for this? Surprise! Fragile warped me here.
Oh, that's why.
I finally got to visit the beach. Well, her beach. Don't worry. I didn't come all this way for the sightseeing. Your beloved BB has a serious issue. You may recall me explaining that these incubators connect BBs via the chiral network to their still mothers back at HQ. Bridge babies are quite literally bridges between this world and the other side. Their place is not here with us, nor with the BTs over there. They belong precisely in between, with no greater affinity for one world or the other. But BB-28 here has been leaning further and further towards the world of the living. Towards you, Sam.
It's because we're partners.
Partners? Sam, a BB's a tool, not a human being. Bridge, yes. Baby, no.
So tell me what the problem is.
This tool, this weapon, is transforming into a living being. It's gaining weight. Its brain activity is increasing. It's accumulating memories. BB-28 is becoming self-aware, becoming an actual child.
Doesn't sound like a problem to me.
It's hardware, Sam. Manufactured for a purpose. A purpose it cannot fulfill outside the pod. There is a 70% risk of catastrophic failure simply in removing it. Which hardly matters because at this point, it'll cease functioning within a couple of days.
Cease functioning?
That's right. Not even the pod will be enough. It'll be bricked.
What do we do?
We reset it. You'll have to leave it with me, of course. I'll cut the cord that links the two of you and then perform an operation that reconnects it to the other side. Think of it as a little tug to correct its alignment, to put it back where it belongs, right between the world of the living and the dead. But like I said, you'll have to be without it for a while.
You're sure this will work?
Of course. One catch, though. The surgery may erase its memories.
Erase? You'll forget me?
Relax. the BB will still function as intended. You just have to trust me. Come on. I'm telling you, it's like a game. Just select retry and start again! And this is why I hate these things. Sam. I was already filthy from my trip through the beach. But now your BB has added insult to injury.
What the fuck was that second look? Yeah, we assume that that's not Hartman at all.
Some digging into the first BB experiments. Officially, they were suspended by the government following a void out which claimed the life of the then acting president. Documents were shredded. BB technology banned, yes? But obviously, the experiments continued in secret on the direct orders of President Strand.
Bridget?
The BBs were essential to solving the mystery of the Death Stranding. Oh, she had big plans for them. They weren't designed just to be BT detectors. She wanted to incorporate them into the chiral network to facilitate travel to the beach. But none of her plans ever came to fruition. And now BB Tech has fallen into terrorist hands.
What's Die Hardman's part in this?
I'm afraid to find out. I don't know how long he was working for Strand. I don't even know his real name or his face. I thought you might, since you two go further back.
He was already wearing a mask when I met him. Something about burning his face.
Right. Sorry. Any data we have from back then is classified at the highest level. As far as I know, the director is the only one with clearance. But the chiral network presents a new opportunity. By compiling fragmented data in the public domain from all across the country, I might be able to piece together a little more of the puzzle. Be careful, Sam. They're watching.
I have a feeling that Hartman will die. The dead man, not Hartman.
Well, Sam, you're a good sport. I'll give you that. Still, it's a fine way to get out of doing the laundry.
Just fix BB, all right?
Oh, no. You'll be doing the fixing. I'd never manage without your help. Check the delivery terminal upstairs for the details. When you're ready, of course.
Well, that was interesting.